Welcome to the Summer School on Effective HPC for Climate and Weather. My name is Julian Kunkel. I'm a professor at the University at Göttingen and also a head of the GBDG HPC team. So I'm co-organizing this workshop and summer school with Jack, who will support me in administrative tasks. So this summer school is supported and actually financed, sponsored by EasyWays, the Center of Excellence in Simulation of Weather and Climate in Europe. What is EasyWays? Well, this EU-funded project represents the European Community for Climate Modeling and Numerical Weather Prediction. The project has goals in respect to HPC environments in order to first improve efficiency and productivity, secondly, to support the end-to-end workflow of global air system modeling, and lastly, to establish demonstrator simulations that run at highest affordable resolutions. So it's one of the center of excellences that have been funded in Horizon 2020 program. And here you find the webpage easyways.eu. Here are the emails again of me and of Jack in case you have any issues. And you want to ask us anything, you can contact us anytime. And in terms of the summer school, we thank the other EasyWays Work Package 6, which is the training work package, for this constructive discussions, feedback, and help to steer the school in the right direction. I also thank the previous co-organizer, which was Luciana Pietro. In terms of agenda, typically Monday till Thursday, we'll find an agenda that looks like this. We start at 9 o'clock. Is a lecture, which is a live session. Then we have a short virtual break, followed by a tutorial. And then we have again a longer break. Starting in the afternoon session, we have a second topic, which is a live session again, is lecture, break, lab tutorial two. And then typically at 1700 hours, it's the end of the day. However, you may continue to work on some live sessions. And of course, depending on the session that we have, we might see some minor adjustments to the schedule. And in one session, you may have multiple presentations and so forth, and multiple different lab tutorials. In terms of topics, that's the list that you find also on the webpage. Monday, which is today, we have computation. Tuesday, we have storage. Thursday, we have data analytics and machine learning. Part of that. Thursday we have supporting tools, and on Friday we wrap up with two invited talks, Q&A for the labs, and some feedback and farewell session. So in terms of how the sessions are organized and in terms of how you can interact, so on the webpage you will find the respective session chairs. They are responsible to moderate the sessions. You are really welcome to give us feedback and involve lively discussions. So if you have any questions or comments, just put them in the big blue button chat anytime, and I will just type something that you can see where it pops up. So it's on the top left, you find public chat, and there you find the chat messages. Yeah, don't worry, just put there what you think. And if there are questions, they will be read out by the session chair, such that they will be part of the recordings and that they are addressed. Of course, you can also ask questions verbally at the end of a lecture session. However, note that we typically record the sessions, hence you will be part of the recording. So the big blue button room will be open all day to support you to interact. And we record only the lectures, typically, and of course the lab sessions. That includes the ask questions. Depending on the needs, you may create breakout rooms, and you should always mute your mic, and moderators can mute you as well if they want. And there is this mailing list that you may have found. Let me paste again. So you can use it to send any issues, but only if this is a matter of general interest, otherwise send it to me or to Jack. Of course, you are allowed to contact the speakers and session chairs after the sessions too. But If they have time, they will reply. Let me phrase it like this. Okay, for the lab sessions, generally we wanted to support the large classes and allow you to make asynchronous progress. There is typically a live session that helps you to overcome initial obstacles, and it may include some extra tasks that you can do in your own pacing, in your own time. There's a virtual machine that was provided as environment to run labs. I know some of you have issues with it, but for most, it typically works. We will create the videos as soon as possible to support you doing those kind of labs. And then you can ask on Friday morning. There's 30 mini sessions for which all the lab session providers will be part of. And then you can ask any question for any topic. And of course, you can discuss, talk with peers about the lab in the big blue button room. Yeah, if you attend most of the sessions, we mean about 70 to 80% of the lectures, then we will email a certificate of attendance after the meeting to you. Therefore, we will capture the attendee list in big blue button, but we only use it for the purpose of creating this certificate and checking that you meet the attendance rate. Okay, we are also working in easy ways with the HPC certification forum. The goal of the HPC certification forum is to establish a fine-grained standardized HPC knowledge representation and to create international certificates that attest the knowledge and to support an ecosystem. This is some work in progress, but hopefully with the things you learn in the summer school, with the topics, you can at some point get a recognized certificate that is international valid, so to speak. Here's the URL of the HPC certification program, and I hope some of you will look further into this approach. So if there are any questions, put it now into the chat, and I will have the answer before we start this our first session. Other than that, I would say, I hope you enjoy the week and have a very good time.